Hello, this series is crammed with information that will teach you everything you need to know about scripting. Every single thing we talk about is vital for a good understanding, even if it doesn't seem like it at first. So please, give me a chance, don't skip any sections, but feel free to pause or go back if you need to. Now to start, let's place a script in the Serverscript service. We'll be using a scripting language called Lua, which is a modified version of Lua. You'll want to make sure that you can see the output, which you can open by clicking View and then Output. Make sure you've got the Explorer and Properties windows open too. Now before we begin, we need to know about three data types. First we have the number, which looks like this. You can type a whole number, or if you're feeling fancy, you can type it as the decimal. Next we have the boolean, which is simply true or false, and looks like this. And finally we have the string, which is just text. In code, we wrap a string in quotation marks, or double square brackets if we want the text to span multiple lines. Now let's declare some variables. Variables can store information in our script which we can refer back to later. First, we need to come up with a name for our variable. We can use letters, underscores, and numbers, as long as it doesn't start with a number. Next, we use the assignment operator, which tells the computer we want to assign a value to our variable. We can then assign a value using any of the data types we mentioned previously. For example, this variable stores a message, this variable stores a boolean, and this variable stores the current year. While not required, it's considered good practice to write variable names like this, which is appropriately called camel case. Now if we want to output a variable, we can call the print function, which is just a fancy way of saying that we want to run or use it. We first type the function name and then round brackets, which tell the computer to call the function. We then hand the function our own values as well as references to our variables. When we run our script, all our values appear in the output, including the values assigned to our variables. This is because the variable name is a reference to its value. Non-existent variables simply output nil, meaning they hold no value. Notice how the values are outputted in the order that we type them. This is because the computer reads our script in order from top to bottom. For example, this script outputs a nil value as the variable is assigned after using it. We can also reassign our variables multiple times like this. With numbers, we can perform mathematical operations using operators. To add 10 and 3, we use the addition operator. This variable is now assigned to 13. This operator is used to subtract, this one multiplies, and this one divides. Finally, this operator calculates a value to the power of another value, and this operator divides and then calculates the remainder of the result. Lua uses order of operations, which you might know as BIDMAS, BODMAS, or PEMDAS. Knowing this, we can write more complex equations using brackets like these. Numbers can also be replaced with references to variables, meaning we can add variables and numbers together. We can then assign the result of those to another variable, or simply pass them as arguments when calling the print function. Additionally, we can use this operator to concatenate two strings, which means to join them. Just as before, we can use this alongside variable references, assign it to a variable, or directly output the result. Finally, we can reassign a variable based on its previous value. For example, this adds 1 to the variable, and then assigns it to the same variable. Now, when learning to script, practicing is vital. That's why I've created a free plugin with challenges and a quiz for each episode in the series. Find the link in the description, and when you're ready, the link for the next episode is there as well. I'll see you soon.